So good morning to one and all present over here. As our name suggests, our tool is NG Hawkeye, network monitoring and simulation tool. So I am Path Kanakya. She is Manvita and she is Pavani. So our project mentor is Amit Srivastava sir. So as the name suggests, it is a tool for network monitoring and simulation. So first of all, I would like to say what is the motivation for developing our application. There are a lot of bandwidth hungry applications. So we need to study them, the testers need to use them, and so forth, so on and so forth. So after to optimize bandwidth usage by analyzing through some tool to simulate the WAN environment. So what happens is that whenever most softwares, when they are tested, they are tested in the LAN environment. Whereas when they deploy their app or when over the web, the web has a lot of bottlenecks. So to simulate those in the WAN impairments in the LAN environment, this tool can be used. So we are testing a software known as Panorama. So what Panorama exactly is, it is a video conferencing application developed by CDIP, IIT Bombay, and was tested with Vanam, an open source tool developed by TCS. It has a lot of limitations. Those limitations, it has some advantages, but it has a lot of limitations too. Those limitations of Vanam motivated us for the need of development of this application. So let me point a few limitations. TCS tool does not have any monitoring. It is a standalone testing machine. Can simulate only one type of network parameter on all clients. It has no mechanism to capture any data. It has no graphical analysis. So what our application does as, so the solution is to use the testing clients to test the application. By testing client, I mean that any client which has a browser on it or any other thing, and it is able to go to assess that website which we want to test. Any application server, so this is what our application is, Panorama, and a capturing machine. So the capturing machine is the heart of our application. So as you can see here, in this diagram, there is one client connected, and there is a server. This is the one which is hosting the Panorama app. And this is our capturing machine. Capturing machine has to be Linux, and it has to have two interfaces. So it, as you can see, the configuration is shown here. I'm moving forward. What are the features of our app? It is a web. It has a web interface, as you can see here. It allows simulation of distinct network parameters. It captures the data. It shows graphs. It also shows some comparative analysis. There is a lot of work to be done more.
So after the monitoring is done, the following parameters, following calculated values are shown. The data that is processed is the total uploaded and downloaded packets, the average number of uploaded and downloaded packets, and the upload and download bandwidth. After that, for these results, interactive graphs are also generated. For simulating the parameters, we use the parameters like delay, loss, and bandwidth. These parameters can be applied to multiple clients, and all the multiple clients can have distinct network parameters. So in the graphs, the interactive graphs will have two types. One would be the bar plot, and the other one is pie chart. So these both graphs would be showing the percentage of size of packets in a defined range. And we can also see the previous results in a defined period of time. We can view static graphs that are generated using R by giving a particular monitoring ID. The key technologies that we have used in our application is, first thing, we have used a Linux machine. Next one is we have used Python for coding. And we have used Django as a framework, which is a Python framework. We have used R for processing our data. MySQL as our database. Nmap is used for scanning the systems. And we have Tshark, TC, and HiCharts. Now we'll move on to the demonstration.
So this is our web-based interface. So we log in. This, as you can see, this IP 154. So that is what I have given here. And so we are actually using our gateway machine. So now, without taking much time, I will go to simulation. Scan the networks which are connected. So it will scan the networks. On this capturing machine, it will scan all the list of networks and show it here. This is done real time. The scanning is used using Nmap. So you have to select all of them which you want to test. Okay. So wait. So now I have selected these four clients, and now I will open the Panorama server to show you that these four clients are actually connected to our video conferencing app. So these are the four clients, client 1, client 2, client 3, client 4. And now I will select the four IPs. So I will give the time. So that time is in seconds, less than the time. 20 seconds. OK. So now when I click on submit, it will capture the packets. Actually, in Panorama, CDF group has also implemented echo cancellation. So on a single click, we can analyze the data. Wait. Show the bandwidth.
Why is there a difference between downloaded packets and total packets? Total packets are normally same.
Total packet?
Uploaded packets and downloaded packets will result into the total packet.
Sir, we give a time. So the packets are passing. 7 minutes. Okay, so we give a time. So the packets are passing through here. Upload is done like this, and download is from this to here. So
my question is,
yes, sir.
Is the same application running on
all the three? Okay.
Nothing else is running on four machines, correct? Only the application, right? It's video conference application. Okay. So shouldn't I expect the same traffic on all four?
Sir, it depends on the webcam quality, and it depends on the in the client configuration. Sir, if the webcam is good enough, it is 5 megapixel. It will show a better quality. It will have a lot number of download. The number of upload packets will be more. So it's like that. If you see in YouTube, it's 720 HD in 720.
No, that's okay. So these four machines have got the same webcam according to you.
I don't know.
You don't know me. You have got data.
So,
live data.
So seeing from this, the number of uploaded packets are nearly the same. So they should have same webcam.
Will it change? They have got a video conferencing tool, correct?
Yes.
Will it change if in a multi-video conferencing tool, okay, depending on the noise level at any terminal, okay, that terminal becomes a sender, correct? Or no?
Depending on noise level at the
yes. terminal. There is a master-slave kind of thing. If there is a lot of noise, if somebody starts speaking at one terminal, then he becomes the main and other people become receivers, correct?
Basically, this is a multi-party video conferencing.
So that is not there. So all are going to be same.
And the upload and download bandwidth depend upon the amount of movement he is doing before the camera. If it is a static, then it will send a similar kind of packet, because the consecutive packets are the difference between the consecutive frames. So if there is a more action, you will have more data passing.
Nothing to do with sound.
Nothing to do with sound. If he is not speaking, then the sound is not transmitted. So again, the bandwidth should reduce. So our actually objective was that to optimize the use of bandwidth by doing all such kind of tactics. We wanted a monitoring tool that actually only visualize what is exactly happening on the network.
So, and Panorama, for all the questions, please, related to Panorama,
okay.
Please
this
ask.
This only shows that it is working. Okay. Where is the report which says that what your boss wanted to do?
So the
your tool gives.
So this is the default one. When I will show the simulation, your question should be answered. Sir, the recent question which you answered, that tool optimal
simulation. I asked about live data capturing. What is the testing you have done? Okay, which shows me that whatever you have done, okay, gives effective data for him to fine tune his panorama or whatever he wants to do.
This is the data. This is the graph. These are interactive.
You are calling it simulation. Simulation data is useless.
So I want actual data. So this is the actual data.
Why are you calling it simulation?
So I said after ahead in time, after 2 minutes, I will show you the simulation. So select the IPs. So this was the actual data. No external parameters were given. Bandwidth.
Some justification like this from the data you have captured, that this fellow is making too much noise, this fellow has got a lot of movement, and that's why packets have increased. That is the thing I want to see. Have you done it?
So the number of packets uploaded.
Yes, so that is what we will show in our comparative analysis.
So that will show. I want to see the from the data, I want information. Okay, you will show me data, I want inference.
And I want a negative inference. So that our software was not able to do it. I danced in front of the machine panorama, and my software did not detect that more packets went. Or I danced and my software detected. That is the test I want to see. Have you done that test?
So that will we had discussed that, but that could not be addressed in this stipulated time.
You could not dance. I got a dancer here. You could have borrowed him.
So I will dance after that.
No, I don't want you to dance. I wanted you to conduct a test, okay, to see, because what he said is that was his objective, correct? Okay, that when there is action, there are more packets. When there is something, there are more packets. So how to utilize bandwidth? Okay, so your tool should at least be tested for that, right?
In more precise way, I will redefine the problem is that what you can do, you show us the normal utilization of bandwidth first. How exactly it is utilizing the bandwidth. Then add some noise to the line from your side itself, right? Add some noise, reduce the bandwidth, and again recapture the thing. And then give us a comparative thing, how exactly the original bandwidth was, and after adding the delay or the reducing the bandwidth, what the output was.
Okay,
is it possible?
We will have to open the Panorama app. It will show some noise.
Why Panorama? You go over here, you define the delay, jitter, what I am going to say, and you show the result.
Okay.
If there is a difference, we will say that it is simulating and it is giving the accordingly result.
Okay, sir. This is the one in which your question will be answered. So we have restricted the bandwidth to 200. We have restricted the kilobits per second. So
what I have asked him to now change the bandwidth of the connections. So that give some terminal to be 200 kbps, other terminal to 100 kbps. And then we will see the what exactly the terminal is providing.
And if you want to see the effect, you can go to that client and see it. See what changes are happening when I input these parameters.
So actually it is a simulation of the network. So although we have got a bigger pipes available, but we can restrict that, we can have the simulation that the terminal is connected to the broadband or the terminal is connected to Wi-Fi. Yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
You are throttling the bandwidth.
Yeah. Yeah, go ahead.
You mentioned
some TCS software.
Yes, sir.
You mentioned it is open source.
Yes, sir.
What was the necessity of writing your own software other than contributing to the open source software?
So first of all, TCS software is a standalone application. It's not web-based. And what now presently is happening is that we are connecting wherever I will, anywhere in the world, I can connect to my machine and I can test. For that TCS software, we will have to install it locally on your machine. It is a software. It is not a web-based UI application. So you will have to...
No. Why did you not enhance it? What's my question? This is the same question he has asked me. Why reinvent the wheel? This has already given you the wheel. You want to put a hubcap on it, put it. So why start with the wheel and I got a hubcap?
So then...
This is what it told me. Huh? So let me see what you answer.
So is it my personal opinion or should I give a modified answer to suit
the needs? Both, yaar.
a personal opinion. Our project is this, so we don't want that we don't want to develop further. We want to start a new application, make a new application.
Perfect.
And the modified answer is, I will do it if I get time in future. Then I will modify that.
You know what answer I gave him on behalf of the team? Okay.
Yes, sir.
That I am better at writing wheels than TCS. So I will reinvent the wheel. What is the point in doing something when I can do it better?
Need is like this. The need was like this. That framework was different. It is only for the LAN. We have to go for the WAN. So the actually requirement was different. We tried. We have used actually TCS tool for a long time. But due to the limitation, we decided finally we have to develop our own. What we can do.
Basically, what he's saying is that was a scooter wheel. We wanted a car wheel.
Thank you.